All things considered, the Flash has been through a lot. Whether he's acted poorly in the past or bad things have just happened to him, there have been a number of rough moments in the hero's history. So, here are 10 of those times. At number 10 is the time that the Flash is forced to fight his partner and childhood best friend, August Hart, aka Godspeed. Godspeed is a villain who kills speedsters, and for a long time, Barry Allen doesn't realize that someone so close to him is behind the mask. Godspeed's motivations start relatively understandably with him searching for revenge against the man who kills his brother. But as it typically goes with bad guys, August goes a bit off the rails and takes on the philosophy that killing is the answer to stopping evil. When Barry finally realizes the true identity of Godspeed, he has no other choice but to fight him, marking one of the sadder moments in the history of the Flash. Luckily, however, Godspeed eventually reforms himself and teams up with Barry to fight Paradox in a high-stakes battle. Still though, this is a pretty rough moment for the Flash, all things considered. At number 9 is the time when the Flash joins evil Superman in the Injustice storyline. When Superman goes evil and splits up the Justice League in the pursuit of world domination, the Flash actually joins him. And it takes a while for him to realize that he's made an error in judgment. Superman even kills Shazam at one point, and this still doesn't change the Flash's mind about the intentions of their mutiny. Now, the idea of the Flash turning evil seems like a really bad moment, and you might be thinking it deserves a higher spot on the list, but considering this event subverts the moral standpoints of multiple characters at once, it doesn't quite have the same impact as if, let's say, the Flash turned bad on his own. I see the Injustice event as being its own standalone case that shouldn't really reflect too seriously on the Flash's overall track record. I mean, Superman changes first. It's hard not to follow in the footsteps of the most powerful superhero on Earth. At number 8 is the time when the Flash turns Inertia into a sentient statue. At one point, Bart Allen, Barry Allen's grandson, ages to a full adulthood and drops the mantle of Kid Flash, taking on the role of Scarlet Speedster and then eventually the Flash himself. But his time as the Flash is short-lived when the Rogues and Inertia team up to kill him. When Wally West takes back the mantle, he immediately hunts down Inertia. And then when he learns that the teen villain isn't even remotely sorry for what he's done, Wally West freezes him, turning him into a statue. But this doesn't kill him either, which I can't tell if that's a good thing or a bad thing, because he still has all his senses and he's totally conscious. Wally puts Inertia into the Flash Museum, leaving him there for years to come, forcing him to watch visitors pass by and observe him as though he's some old dusty relic in a museum. This is a pretty brutal punishment, putting into question whether or not it's even worse than just killing the guy, although it honestly feels pretty deserved. We can't help but think there was maybe another way to handle this one. At number 7 is the time when the Flash forces Zoom to relive his worst memory over and over again. This is the result of Zoom attacking Wally West's wife, Linda, and hitting her with a sonic boom that kills her unborn child. Now, you can imagine at this point, the Flash's whole moral compass would come into question. The whole superhero code of no killing becomes more of a roadblock than ever here, so Wally decides to take a workaround. When he finally catches Zoom, he freezes the pesky villain in a single moment in time, forcing Zoom to watch the worst day of his life on repeat for the rest of eternity. Now, I don't know what happens when we die, but if it's anything other than being forced to relive your worst memory over and over again, I'd imagine Zoom was wishing that Wally had just broken that old superhero code just this once. At number 6 is the time when the Flash dies during the Crisis on Infinite Earths storyline. In a moment of sacrifice, Barry Allen uses his powers to dismantle the Anti-Monitor's antimatter cannon, but in doing so, he essentially runs himself into a skeleton, moving so fast that he dissolves before everyone's eyes. But it works, leaving the Anti-Monitor with no other options in that moment, and when he thinks he'd otherwise won the day and defeated the heroes of planet Earth. Although this is a very sad and awful moment for the Flash, it's also one of his best moments as well, in a way. It shows everyone how far Barry Allen would go to save his fellow teammates and the people of the world, which kind of evens out how devastating his death is. If he died any other way more tragically, this would be at number 1. But the context of his sacrifice sort of lightens the blow on this one for me. At number 5 is the seminal moment of Barry Allen's mother's death. Cited as a pivotal moment in the Flash's origin story, the death of Nora Thompson, Barry's mother, marks one of the worst moments in the Flash's history by a long shot. And to make things worse, Barry Allen's own father is framed for the crime, which leaves the future hero orphaned during most of his childhood. Later in the Flash storyline, it's revealed that the murderer had actually been Reverse Flash and not his father, which only makes the whole event that much more confusing and devastating. The only reason why this moment isn't higher on the list is that it's arguably one of the reasons why the Flash becomes as powerful and influential as he does. Humanity gets a lot of good out of this event in a strange, twisted sort of way, so I just pushed it a bit back on the list. At number 4 is the time that the Flash mind wipes the entire world. When he realizes that he'd be much safer if no one knew his secret identity, he decides that he should go back on his previous decision to reveal who he is to the world. So he approaches Hal Jordan and asks to wipe the minds of, well, everyone on Earth. It's such a powerful mind wipe that even he forgets that he was ever the Flash in the first place, for a time. But all in all, in the comic book world, it is pretty frowned upon to wipe people's memories for obvious reasons, so this makes it higher on the list. It's not quite as bad since he targeted only the memories regarding him as the Flash, but still, it's not one of the most respectable moves by the speedster. At number 3 is the time when the Flash drives the Top insane. During the Identity Crisis event, the infamous villain the Top, worst name, is the subject of an experiment. Barry Allen wants to see if he can mind wipe the bad out of this bad guy. He gets Zatanna to mind wipe him, leaving him kind of like a good guy after the procedure. But soon after, the now good guy, the Top, starts to remember his past evil deeds and basically goes insane. His guilt surmounts to a point where he pretty much ends his own life. This is another instance of the Flash playing around with mind wiping without considering the consequences, but it's not entirely his fault in my opinion. He was just trying to give the Top a chance of being better. At number 2 is the death of Iris. The longtime love interest of the Flash, Iris West Allen, has been around throughout the many different iterations of the Flash, and even though they have a pretty rocky relationship at times, Iris's death comes as a shock to not only the readers but to the Flash as well. And you best believe that it's once again at the hands of Reverse Flash. Literally at his hands, he pushes his hands into Iris's forehead and basically scrambles her brains, killing her instantly. This leaves Barry Allen in shambles, naturally, and although we do see Iris make a return later on in the comics, this event is hugely pivotal for the Flash, changing him forever and strengthening his hatred for Reverse Flash in the process. At number 1 is the one and only Flashpoint. Not only is this one of the most significant events in the Flash's life, but it's also considered one of the worst things to happen to the whole DC universe. After he's brought back to life in Final Crisis, the Flash decides he needs to go back in time to prevent the death of his mother. But once again, we see Barry Allen lacking foresight with the consequences of not mind wipe this time, but time travel. And when he returns to the present, the whole world has changed. Most of the world is destroyed due to a war between Wonder Woman and Aquaman. Superman is now a secret government prisoner. And Batman is dead instead of his father, leaving Thomas Wayne as a murderous version of Batman. The Flash then has to go back in time and undo the events of Flashpoint, which sparks the beginning of the New 52. But some time there, the Flash instigates one of the most damaging events in the Flash's and all of the DC Comics history. Alright, that was the list for today, gang. Did I miss anything? Leave it all down below in the comments and I'll do my best to answer you. If you enjoyed the video, leave a thumbs up and subscribe if you haven't already. This has been Top 10 Nerd. I've been your host Ben Ball, you know the rest.